glad to see all of you gathered in the old corral once again for another song fest. I noticed that Wade's got his hair all greased up with axle grease there.
That means
Sally must be here. Well, we hope so, because whenever she's around, all the boys really put vim and vigor into their music. With all kidding aside, folks, we're mighty happy to have you with us, and we'll all relax a spell now and listen to what the kids have to offer. Keith, you look like you'd love to get us started here with a song.
Oh, I would, Pappy, I would. I'm all ready to go.
All right, let's head out west in Texas,
all
huh?
Right.
Way out west in Texas, that's where I long to be. Riding on the prairie with a good horse under me. 3 long years I've bummed around, my heart is sad and blue. I'm going back to the woolly west where your friends are always true. Way out west in Texas, where the atmosphere is light. You roll up in your blanket on the prairie every night, where rattlesnakes and old horned toads sleep right by your side. On the desert sands of Texas, that's where I long to ride. Way out west in Texas, around that old campfire, we sang the song not long ago and I strummed on the old guitar. My heart is ever yearning and I hope I'll be there soon. I'll settle down in Texas when the cactus is in bloom. Way out west in Texas, when they round up in the spring, you'll hear me sing this little song while I'm riding on the range. Your Broadway lights appeal to you, but moonlight suits me fine. So I'll settle down in Texas and leave my blues behind.
Curly, suppose you get up here close, and I'll get the boys around you, and you break loose on the tune first, will you?
All right, Pat.
Here we go. That boy was on the second rail that time, wasn't he? Well, he had the wagon rolling. Well, how about the choir sing a little song for us? We got a little old song here called Round Up in Cheyenne, I think. Sally, will you kind of help the boys a little bit?
I'd love to, Pat.
Right. Let's go, boys. call nice harmonizing, kids. You know, it reminds me of a roundup Chuck Davis had once. Yes, I'll never forget it. Yeah, Chuck Davis owned the Bar DZ Ranch some years ago, and Harry Lasker came to the Bar DZ after his dad died to go to work for Chuck. Harry worshipped him because, you see, Chuck and his dad have been such real pals. And he tried every way in his power to show Chuck just how useful he could make himself. Besides roping and branding and riding herd, Harry studied the livestock market and got government books on correct feed and grazing and so forth. Well, the Bar DZ was just a little outfit then, and Chuck was losing money every season, just about ready to give up. Well, Harry kept deviling him to make changes and do this and do that, and then one day Chuck's foreman got mad and quit. He said he was tired of having a little runt not dry behind the ears telling him what to do. And Chuck was fit to be tied, and he told Harry, he says to him, "You know so much, maybe I ought to make you the foreman now and let you run the ranch to suit yourself." Well, Harry kind of grinned, kind of weak-like, and he said, "Well, I'll do the best I can, Uncle Chuck." So Chuck made him the foreman, figuring things couldn't be any worse. Well, things went all right till just before fall roundup. Chuck and the other ranchers were ready to ship their beef when a spell of bad weather come up, and one storm after another called the canyon to kind of flood a little bit and scattered the cattle all over the countryside. Chuck says to Harry, we won't try to bring the yearlings in till this stormy weather's over. Another couple of weeks won't hurt them none. They're sheltered over there under the bluffs. But Harry didn't agree. He says, "I think we ought to bring them in, storm or no storm, Uncle Chuck. I've been studying the stock market, and I think, well, that's just about as far as you got." Chuck says, "I don't care what you think. You do what I tell you." Well, that night, the storm got worse. And Harry got kind of worried about the cattle. Yeah, he rode out of the corral on his pony, straight for the other side of the canyon. It was daylight when he got back, driving 200 head of balling muddy beef. And when he had them all in the pen, he fastened the gate and turned his pony around, and there stood Chuck, right out in the rain. And he was so mad the raindrops were barely sizzling when they touched him. He says, "I got no place for tin horn heroes on my ranch. Here's your pay, and I'll get it going." Harry didn't say nothing, but his chin was trembling as he rode away. It wasn't until a couple of days later that Chuck learned from Doc Stanley that he'd patched up 3 broken ribs and a busted shoulder for Harry. Doc says, "Harry got pretty badly banged up when he headed the stampede of your beef from going over into the canyon during the storm. They broke out of the bluff corral and was running wild when Harry found them and drove them over to the ranch." Chuck sold the beef for a nice profit then. 2 weeks later, when all the other ranchers dumped their beef on the market, the bottom dropped out of the price and lots of them went bankrupt. After that, Chuck didn't talk much about Harry Lasker. Only once, he says to me, he says, there's only one thing worse than finding out your idol's got feet of clay. And that's have that idol kick you in the pants. Well, sir, he says, I guess I'm the wrong stuff to make an idol out of. So that just goes to show you, you don't know who to put your confidence in. And that's my story for this time, kids. How about one of you singing a little song, eh?
Well, Pappy, if it's all right with you, I'd love to sing a song.
Look at that boy's eyes sparkle over there. I knew it. All right, boys, let's have it. The cowboy serenade,
yes,
sir. Almost there, and he's This is Pappy Cheshire talking for all the boys and girls and Sally. Saying so long, everybody.
So long.
Low.